people use stories to express the world around them. They also use stories to talk to the creator and to talk to animals and birds and things like that. So when I was younger, my parents used to tuck me into bed and read me a bedtime story. My favorite book was The Rainbow Fish. So this book had obviously pictures and words right in front of you that you can see. With First Nations storytelling, everything is oral, so you have to use your imagination. I would rather be told a First Nations oral story when I was younger because I feel like it would make my imagination now more vivid, and I guess you could say I would be more creative now. First Nations storytelling has so much more meaning behind it. As a child, or like a child's book, it usually doesn't have a significant meaning behind it. With First Nations stories, they always have morals or meaning. And I also noticed that First Nations stories usually have an appreciation for them in something. I also saw a couple of quotes from a TED Talk that I watched. One was, "It takes one tree to make 10,000 matches, but it only takes one match to burn down 10,000 trees." The other one was, "If all insects died, in 50 years the world would end. But if all humans died, in 50 years the world would flourish." So basically these mean that you have to respect the world around them. So I like to compare First Nations stories to quotes because they have a meaning, and so does First Nations stories. And every single quote and every single First Nations story is different, and that's what makes them special.